Hi, and welcome back to another tutorial on Zapier. In this tutorial, I'm going to be looking at filters, and if that's of interest to you, then keep watching. Hi, I'm Andrew Mean, and I help businesses to save money and time by automating the repetitive tasks and mundane tasks that they carry out on a daily or regular basis. In this video, we're going to look at filters. I'm going to go through each of the options in the Zap filter app. Now, some of these you may have come across before, but I'm going to go through each of them individually, just in case you're new to Zapier or new to filters and you want to understand what each of them does. I will break up the video into sections so you can jump to the particular option that you want if you're just looking for one individual option. I'm also going to provide this in a download, so if you'd like to get that, again, you can get that information in the description. So before we start listing the options available in the Zapier filter module, let's have a quick look at how you would use it on the program itself. So I've got a Zap here, very simple Zap, two-step Zap with a new email arrives, and once it's arrived, upload any attachments to Google Drive. In this case, I want to add a filter. So we'll click the filter option, and then we'll choose the field that we're going to filter against. And in this case, let's choose the subject, and the email I've got already pulled through has confidential email as the subject. So if we click and choose condition, you'll see that there are many conditions here, and we'll go through each of those in detail later on in the video. But for now, let me show you how to use just the first one. So we select text contains, and we enter the value that we want to find. And then we click continue, and it will test. And because the text that we're searching, which was the subject, and our subject says confidential data, the text was found and the Zap would have continued. If I put in urgent, it will fail, because the text does not appear in the subject line and you can see it's failed. So now that we've seen the module, let's have a look at each of the individual options and we'll go through what each of those means in detail. So the first search phrase is text contains. The purpose of this is that the Zap will only continue if the block of text you're searching through contains the word or words that you're searching for. So in our example here, example one, we have a subject for an email which says confidential email, and we're searching for the word confidential. In that case, the Zap would continue, it would pass. In example two, the text being searched is confidential email again, but we're searching for the word urgent, so in that case, it won't pass. Now what's important to note about this and all the text filters is that it's not case sensitive. So had we searched for confidential with a lowercase c, the first example would have continued. Our next term is text does not contain. So in this case, the Zap will only continue if the text being searched does not contain the word or phrase that we're searching for. So in this case, in example one, the text being searched is urgent email and we're searching for the word confidential. Confidential doesn't appear in the phrase urgent email, so the filter will pass. Had we searched for the word urgent, as in example two, then the filter would not pass because urgent appears in the body of the text that we're looking at. And again, this is not case sensitive. Text exactly matches. In this case, the block of text that we're searching through must exactly match the search term. So in the last examples, we were searching for a word or phrase which needed to be within the text. In this case, the search phrase must match exactly what we're searching through. So in the example one, confidential email, we're searching as the subject and we're searching for the phrase confidential email. So this would continue because the phrases exactly match. Had we searched for urgent email, it wouldn't have passed because the subject is confidential email and clearly that doesn't match. And again, it's case insensitive. Text is not exactly match. In this case, the Zap will only continue if the block of text we're searching through doesn't match the text that we're searching for. So in this case, if we're searching through a block of text that says the swift brown fox jumped over the lazy hen, and we search for the swift brown fox jumped, then the filter will pass because it doesn't exactly match the phrase we're searching through. On the other hand, if we searched for the swift brown fox jumped over the lazy hen, it wouldn't pass because the two phrases match and it's not case sensitive. Text is in. This is a slightly more complicated one to understand. So the purpose of this is that the Zap will continue only if the text being searched matches a word or phrase in a list that we provide. So in example one, we have the text being searched as apples and bananas. And we have a list which is separated by commas. We have two things in the list. It's apples and bananas and pears and apples. So in this case, the filter would pass because the text we're searching does appear in the list. Apples and bananas is part of the list. In example two, we're still searching for apples and bananas, or we're searching through the text apples and bananas. And the search value this time is apples and pears and bananas and apples. So two search terms, apples and pears and bananas and apples. In this case, the filter won't pass because it doesn't match either of the items in the list. And it's not case sensitive. Text is not in. In this case, the Zap will continue only if the text being searched does not appear in a list of items that we're searching for. So in this case, in example one, if we're searching through the phrase apples and bananas, and our list contains two phrases, grapes and bananas and pears and apples, remember it's separated by a comma, then the filter will pass because our text isn't part of those phrases. Example two, again, we're looking at the text apples and bananas, and the search value is apples and bananas and apples. Now, in this case, the filter won't pass because it does match. It matches one of the phrases in our list, and it's not case sensitive. Text starts with. So in this example, the filter will only continue if the word or phrase that we're searching for is at the beginning of the block of text we're searching through. So in example one, we've got subject heading that says confidential email message, and we want to search for confidential email. In this case, the filter will pass, the Zap will continue, because confidential email is exactly how the phrase starts. If our subject said urgent confidential email, and we wanted to search for confidential email, it would not pass, because urgent is the first word, and we haven't searched for the word urgent. Text does not start with. In this case, the filter will only pass if the text we're searching for is not the first word or phrase in the text we're searching through. So in example one, confidential email message, and we're searching for email message, it will pass, it will continue, because confidential is the word it started with, and that is not what we're searching for. Had the subject, as in example two, been confidential email message, and we searched for confidential email, then the filter won't pass because that is how it starts. And remember, we're searching for text does not start with. Text end with, this is the opposite to text starts with. So in this case, the filter will only pass if the word or phrase we're searching appears at the end of the text we're searching through. So in this example, we have a subject, email message hyphen confidential, and we're searching for the word confidential. And because that is the last word, the filter would continue, the Zap would continue. In example two, it would not continue because we're searching for the word confidential, which appears at the beginning of the phrase, confidential email message. And in that case, it wouldn't continue. Text does not end with. In this case, the Zap will continue only if the text being searched through does not end with the text we're searching for. So in this case, we're using the subject again, email message confidential, and we're searching for the value email message. And the filter will pass because the phrase does not end with email message. In example two, we're using the word confidential. And of course, the filter will not pass because it does end with the word confidential. And we're searching for text that doesn't end with. Number greater than. Now this may seem fairly obvious, but let's go through it anyway. The Zap will only continue if the number we're searching is greater than the number we put in our search field. So if we're searching against the number 1500 and we put in the value 1000, then the filter will pass because 1500 is clearly greater than 1000. If we search for 1500, the filter won't pass because 1500 is not greater than 1500, it exactly matches. So that's important to know, it's got to be greater. And if we search for the value 1600, it wouldn't pass because 1500 is less than 1600. Number less than. So in this case, the filter will only pass, the Zap will only continue, if the number is less than the one we use in our search term. So in this case, 1500, our search value is 1600, so the filter will pass. If we use the number 1500, it would not pass because 1500 is exactly the same and it needs to be less than to pass. And similarly, if we use 1000 as our search value, the filter would not pass, it would not continue. Date time after. In this case, the Zap will only continue if the date and the time that we're searching falls after the date and time we put in the search value. So in example one, we've got the 19th of November 2020 at 15:42, and our search value is the 1st of January 2020 at 9 o'clock. In that case, the Zap would have continued because our date is after the search value. In example two, if we'd put in the 1st of January 2021 instead, the Zap would not continue because clearly the 19th of November is before the 1st of January 2021. Now, in example three, we've got exactly the same time and date. In that case, the filter won't pass because it's not after. It has to be after. So exactly the same date, it still won't pass. Date and time before. In this case, the Zap will only continue if the date and time is before the date that we place in the search value. So in example one, we use the same dates, 19th November 2020, and our search value is the 1st of January 2021. In this case, the Zap would continue because our date falls before that. In example two, exactly the same date, but this time our search value is the 1st of January 2020. So this Zap won't pass because our date is not before the date that we searched. Our example three shows that if the date and time are exactly the same, it will not pass because it has to be before the exact same date, it will fail. Date time equals, in this case, the Zap will only continue if the date and time exactly matches the date and time that we're searching for. So in this case, we've got a date and time of 19th November 2020 at 15:42 and 1 second. And if we have that as a search value, as we have here, the filter will pass, the Zap will continue. In example two and three, we've got our search value being 1 second after and 1 second before. And in both those cases, they will fail because it has to be exactly the same. The date and time has to equal. Next, we have exists. In this case, the Zap will only continue if the field we're searching contains some data. So for example, if we're searching an email subject field and it contains the words confidential email or any words, then the Zap will continue. If, as in example two, the subject field is empty, it doesn't exist, Therefore, the Zap will not continue. Our final example is does not exist. So in this case, the Zap will only continue if the field we're searching is empty, so if no data exists. So in our example, if we've got an email subject field that is blank, it's empty, the filter will continue because it doesn't exist. If, however, the email subject was confidential email, then the filter would not allow the Zap to continue. Well, I hope you found that video useful. If you did, click like and subscribe to our YouTube channel and share the video with others so that they can benefit from the knowledge that you've gained today. Thanks again for watching.